Hello to everybody students. Let us come back to our lesson children. In the last class I have explained you the half of the lesson. That means I have divided this lesson, which is our lesson children, a homework. Okay, see reading part from the page number. Which page number I have told children? I have told you the page number 60 in the last class. Now today I am going to start the page number in the page number 61 children. Everybody should open the page number 61. So here we have discussed about what children? We have discussed about the problem faced by the children due to the issue of homework. Yes or no? Not only the children, the parents also. Okay. Now let us see what is happened children. We have discussed that what problem they have faced in the due to the case of homeworks. Yes. Many children have admitted in the hospitals in US. Yes. Many children have admitted in the US in the hospital due to the issue of homework only. So last class I have explained from the page number 61. Which paragraph children? The third paragraph. Let us see the last point of the second paragraph. What is that? However, cutting the time out of the few hours a week teenagers use for exercise could be a factor in the growing obesity cases. Okay children, growing the obesity cases means the obesity cases are growing due to what children? Due to the hours. That means the time is not getting for the students or for the children. For what purpose? For doing the activities. Which activities? Playing, yes, walking, and spending the time with the family members. Okay, next one children, next paragraph let us see. The number of children who are overweight has doubled in the last 2 to 3 decades. That means he is telling that, what is telling children? This point is telling that last 2 or 3 decades. Decades means what? 10 years. Last 10 to 20 years back, what is happened children? The number of children have, okay, the number of children who are overweight. Overweight means what? The children who are fat, they are called the overweight. Who has overweight has doubled in the last 2 to 3 decades. Okay. Now, currently one child out of 5 is overweight. Currently, that means presently, currently one child over of 5 is overweight. What he is telling? He is telling that from out of 5 children, one child is overweight. These children are faced with more problems in schools. So, okay, the children who has obesity problem, okay, who are facing with obesity. Obesity means what children? The fat children. Okay, the children who are fat, they are facing many problems in schools. Instead of learning and concentrating on their work, many children are developing low self-esteem and even depression because of teasing. That means they are going backward direction. Okay, the children who are fat, they are going in a backward direction. Why? Because they are just fed up with and they are just went into the depression. Why? Because they are fat and some children are teasing on them. Yes or no children? And what children? Instead of learning and concentrating on their work, many children are developing low self-esteem. Low self means low self-respect. That means the children are not respecting to each other. That means you will find different types of children. Okay, different types of children in a class. Some are thin, some are fat, some are slim. Okay, different types of children are seen. So one child is teasing for the another. Yes or no? So in this way, some children are getting disturbed. Okay, disturbed due to this reason. Next, the cases of obesity are growing mostly certainly due to lack of physical exercise. Why these cases are growing, children? The obesity cases are growing due to lack of physical exercise. That means the children are not participating in the physical exercises. Physical exercise means not participating in running. Yes, after going home, they are just catching the book and sitting at one place and they are not walking for few distance also. Okay, next one. With more and more homework being assigned, kids simply do not have enough time for proper amount of exercise. That means with more and more homework, that means when the homework is given by the teacher, a lot of homework given by the teacher, okay, assigned, kids simply do not have enough time for proper amount of exercise. When they have a lot of work, when they have a lot of homework, they are unable to do the exercise. Yes or no? If we do the work at home, if you carry any load of 10 kg, 5 kg daily in the morning, in the evening, it will also become one exertion. If you do some work also, it is also one exercise. But we are sitting at one place and we are going on writing. The children are going on writing the homework. Means what happened? There is no physical exercise for the children. Okay. With more and more homework being assigned, kids simply do not have enough time for proper amount of exercise. Next one. Next paragraph, children. Homework also take away the time that a kid could be spending with his or her family. Okay, homework is taking off the time. Off the time. Okay, that means they are not sparing a little amount of time also in front of their family members due to the homework. Due to a lot of homework, they are not spending with their parents. Okay, children. Next. Rather than spending time bonding and building strong family relationship, parents and children are argue over homework. Okay. They are not getting a lot of time. Okay. They are not getting the time to spare with their children. Why? Because if a parent go and call for a child and he give the response in what way? Father, I have some work. I have homework. I am doing the homework in that way. So that means the parents are not sparing the time and the children equally not sparing the time with the parents. Okay. Next one. Time is taken away from important aspects of daily life. Okay. Time is very auspicious, children. Very important in our daily life. Okay. Whatever we are doing the work, it is done in time only. So time and tide, no wait for men. But proverb is the children. Already you might have heard this proverb, I think. Time and tide, no wait for men. That means whatever the work is done in time, that is mentioned for that purpose only. In that time, if we are going to do the another work, means it is not possible. We cannot reach our goals. Got? Next. This time is particularly precious in families with both the parents working. Yes or no? So the time is very important. Precious means what, children? The time is very important between whom, children? Between the parents and the children also. The time spent by such parents with their children is very limited. So the parents are telling that whatever the time they are spending with the children at home is very limited. Why? Because the children are very busy in writing the homeworks only. Okay. This time could be better spent going out. So when they come from the school, so that time is the good time for the children or for the family members to take their children. To take the children going out to dinner as a family, with a family. It is a good time. Evening time, it is good, no? But actually what is happening here? Much time is spared by the children in writing the homeworks. The parents are not interested for the parents are getting less time to take their children for a dinner or doing other activities that most families are not able to do because, if they want to do any activities, the parents will plan after coming children from the school, we want to do this work. Already they have planned. But actually what the children are doing here, the children are coming from the school and they are just catching up the books for writing the homeworks. Okay. Not able to do because the kids don't have time to take a break from their homework schedule. Okay. So whatever the schedule is done by the students, by the children, actually they will be making the schedule from the school itself. Yes, English teacher has given some homework, Telugu teacher has given, mathematics sir has given some homework. They will plan and come from the school. Okay, according to the time, they will do that homeworks. Okay, so what is happening when they are doing this? A lot of homework, they are just avoiding all the activities which they want to perform in that age. Okay, next, children, when assignments are given carelessly and frequently, it causes student to lose interest in the subject. Now, the main important point. See, homework not given by the teacher is not good. Yes, homework should be given by the teacher, but it should be a limit. Yes or no? So here, what is telling? When assignments are nothing but children, homeworks are given carelessly and frequently. Means, carelessly means a lot of homework or the homeworks are given daily by a teacher. It causes student to lose interest in the studies. What happens, children, when we are giving with the teacher? Being a teacher, if I give a lot of homework for the student, for me, that means for the 9th class student, what happens? They will be remove the interest from my subject. Okay, if all the teachers are giving the same homework, a lot of homework, means what happens, children? All the students will do the same. They will just to neglect the studies. They will remove the interest from the subject. Next, negative result can also occur when a student is not able to complete. Yes or no? Negative result can also occur when a student is not able to complete. If the student is not able to do the homework, means what happened? Negative result will come. Negative. Yes, if a teacher has assigned one homework, if you have not done in the next day, what happened? The negative result will be coming from the teacher side. Got? Next one. So, to complete his or her homework, many times they will resort to copying the homework. What happens, children, if this result happens, if the negative result comes, what happens? Many times they utilize to copying the homework, or else what they will do? Having others to do their assignment. Suppose some parents are doing the homeworks. You know, children, we have come across this type of cases. Okay, whatever the homeworks are assigned to the students, parents are doing the homework and sending their children writing in their notebooks, or cheating in test, or cheating. So this type of negative results will occur in the student. What they will do? They will utilize the more time in copying the homework, or having others to be written their homework, or cheating. They will learn one new habit, dirty habit. What is that? Cheating in test. Next, bad habits such as this are likely to haunt kids through their lives and have an adverse effect on their moral judgment. That means the bad habits such as, so these type of habits are very bad, children. Cheating in the examination, yes, making your homework to write with your parents or with your brothers, yes or no? See, these all are the bad habit. So such bad habits, okay, such bad habits happen in you, means what happen? That means haunt kids, that means the ghost will attack you. Yes or no? The ghost will attack you. How the ghost will attack you? The ghost and coming and not catching for you. Ghost kids mean haunt kids means nothing but something the ghost has entered in your body, like that feeling you will get. Though their lives and have an adverse effect, and they also have, the students will have the negative effect on their moral judgment. Okay, children, next line. Students will almost always take the easy way when it comes to homework. Yes or no? So when the homework time comes, what happens, children? Mostly the children will take the easy way. They will take the easy way. That means tomorrow we will write the homework. Day after tomorrow we will write the homework. Why I should write the homework? Okay, this type of thought will get by the children. Next one. The use of homework is effective when used by the rule. So the use of homework, whatever the homework is assigned by the teachers, no? It is assigned in this way, children. The use of homework is effective. Effective means it is useful. When it is useful? When used by the rule. When all the teachers are using this rule. What is that? Less is more. Giving the less homework and giving the more techniques or using the less homework and giving the more knowledge. Got, children? Using the less homework and giving the more knowledge to the children. Next one. Overwhelming kids. Overwhelming means what, children? Very great. Overwhelming. Meaning it is given in the glossary. Overwhelming is nothing but very great. So, very great kids with loads of homework can cause them stress and possible physical injury. So, if the kids have lot of loads to carry to the school, from school to the home, okay, what is happened, children? They will be caused with cases. The cases are caused. Which type of cases will cause, children? Stress and possible physical injury, and possible, that means they will get the physical injuries also in their body. Next, homework takes away from small amount of time kids get to spend with their parents and siblings. That means homework is taking away. That means when the children are doing the homework, what is happening? They are just separating the relationship between the parents and the siblings. Siblings are nothing but children, brothers and sisters. Okay, so homework takes away from the small amount of time kids. Whatever the time is paid by the parents to the students, okay, that is removed off. Okay, get to spend with their parents and sibling. Next, a limit on their physical and social activities can also take a large toil on their lives. That means a limit on their physical and social activities can also take a large toil. Toil means hard or unpleasant work, and could hinder their health and future relationship. Okay, children. Next paragraph. Here hinder is given. What is the meaning of the hinder here? To make it difficult for somebody to do something. That means they are finding very difficult, children. The children are feeling very difficult to face the situation. Which type of situation? The homeworks which are assigned. They are feeling very difficult. A limit on their physical and social activities can also take a large toll. That means it can be taken as a hard work on their lives. Life means what? Life, children. Lives are nothing but plural form of life. And could hinder their health and future relationship. Hinder means it will make their health difficult to live in the future relationship. Okay, last point, children, now. This is not only to say that homework could be abolished. Okay, so whatever the negative points told from this lesson, so it should be taken as a positive way only. Whatever the negative thoughts are told by the parents, by the students, it can be taken as a positive way. Where, children? In the institution. Yes, so the complaint will be coming where? The complaints will come in the institution. You know, my child is writing the lot of homework and he is getting sick. This kind of complaints you will get. So to avoid this, what is happened, what is told for the student? This is not to say that homework should be abolished. That means if the student have this type of doubt, we are not able to remove the homework. Abolish means what, children? Remove. But it should be limited. That means the homework is given. The homework should not be given in a large form. It can be given in a limited. Okay. The homework should also be creative and interesting so that the child enjoys it. Whenever the teacher is going to give any homework, children, what is happened? The homework should be very interesting for the children to do, and they will be doing that homework with enjoyingly. They are going to do the homework. So that type of homework we should have to assign for the student. That is told from this lesson, children. So okay. So we have completed the lesson. Everybody should write some difficult words. Some means 20. Much difficult words are there, children. 20. Find any 20 difficult words from this lesson. Write 20 difficult words. Mention the lesson name. Homework. Write 20 difficult words. After difficult words, write the glossary. How many are there, children? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That means 10 meanings are there. 10 meanings you should have to write and learn. Next, question answers I will be sending you in the next class, children. Question answers. Now, project work. A small project work is there. I will explain you that you should have to do this project work in your textbook itself. Okay. Conduct a survey. Heading is given. See in the textbook, children. Page number 63. Project work. Conduct a survey to find out the kind of reading material the children like to be included in the textbook, which makes the book more interesting. That means to create some interest in the student. Which type of reading material should be included, given in the textbook? That is given. Okay. So they have made one. Conduct a survey. That means we should have to conduct a survey. Got, children? Ask them which of the following they enjoy most and complete the table. That means I am asking you, children, which one you like? Comics. Are you able to like the comics? Sir, we don't know the meaning of comics, sir. Comics are nothing but the amusing, making laugh stories. Some stories are there, children. We will find some stories in the textbook now. Lesson. Stories are nothing but the lesson. which type of lessons you are able to see? The amusing, adventurous, you can tell, or you can tell making laughful. If you are getting laugh by hearing the story, this type of stories are called cosmic children. Next one, biographies. Biography means what? History children, history of any person. After the completion of the lesson, we will see about the author. So that type of bits already it is included in your textbook children. This type of bits, biographies. Next, playlets means what? It is one type of skits children. Playlets. Next one, skits also. Skits, everybody know drama, you will tell no skits. Next one, scientific essays. Scientific essays means one topic about the scientist. Okay, suppose about one machinery also you can tell machinery. Scientific essays. Next one, folklore. folklore. Folklore means what, children? Folklores are nothing but these are the stories about the tradition. stories about the tradition or stories of countries, different countries. Everybody knows songs. We will be having different types of songs also. We will get the songs like a poem. Next one, essays, children. Essays are nothing but description. Got? Next one, poems. You know about the poems. Many poems are included in the textbooks, in English textbooks. Next, fairy tales. Fairy tales means what, children? The stories about magic. Magic stories you can tell, children. So fairy tales. Next one, stories. Any story. Long ago there lived a big lion or some other person, whatever it may be. So stories. Next one, jokes. Jokes also, children. Next one, news reports. We will find the news reports in the newspaper, no? So that type of news reports also we can come across with that. That should be included in the textbooks. Next one, children, diaries. Who will maintain the diary? A person will maintain the diary. He will mention all the things, all the incidents which occur in his life in the diary. Next one, magazines. Magazines means what, children? Weekly you will get, no? Weekly or monthly you will get the newspaper. In that newspaper you will find the magazine. What is present in that magazine? Articles are present. What is present, children? Articles or the stories are present. Next one, last one is speeches. Okay, speeches. So this all should be included in the textbook to become the our syllabus less. This point should be added in the textbook. He is telling. Now work in group and consolidate the data you have collected. Collect the data in the given format. 1 to 5 he has given, children. 1 to 5, name of the child. That means you can mention any name. You can mention your name also. Mention the name of the child. Material liked. Which material he liked? Suppose, in 9th class, Vasant is there. Vasant, name of the child, Vasant. Material liked. Which type of material you liked? Suppose you like the biographies. Okay, material like this, biography you can write. Biography. So, title, you should have to mention the title. Biography, about whom you are writing. You should have to mention that person name, title, biography, about that person. Or if you want to write any diary. Okay, material like diary. Whose diary title? Vasant diary you can write. My personal diary you can write. Okay, in that way. If you want to write any essay, you can mention any essay. About environmental day, you can mention. Yes, material like to essay. Material like essay by Yogita in the class. Okay, Yogita, name of this child, Yogita. Material like essay, name of the essay, title means environmental day. You can mention. Next one, children. So, in that way, you should have to mention any 5 student name along with your name. Okay, along with your name, 5. Then afterwards, prepare a pie chart with the collected data. Pie chart means what, children? The round circle will be, yes. From that, we are going to divide the percentages. Out of 100%, it will be 15%. Somebody are liking what? Somebody liking jokes, somebody are liking magazines, and some children are liking speeches. Okay, overall, from 5 students, you should have to give 100%. You should have to share the information in 100%. 50%, 50%, 50, how much, children? It will become 65. Okay, like that. You should have to divide this all the pie diagram into 100%. Got? So analyze the pie chart and name the material they enjoyed reading. So okay children, so this is the small homework for you assigned by from me children. Okay, so you should have to draw the pie chart also, and you should have to complete this box. Okay, you should have to complete this box. So this is the topic children, I have explained in the class. I have explained the half of the lesson, that is homework, and I have explained about the project work. Project work, you know? Yes, project work. It is a small homework given to you. So do the homework children, compulsorily.